इट इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ वेरिएशन चैप्टर दैट इज द सेकेंड वीडियो. नाउ इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक इट इज गिवन दैट इफ एक्स वेरीज एज y directly with y and inversely with z, then calculate the value of x. This is question number 4-2. Now x directly varies y means x varies y, you will write down in this way when z is constant, and inversely with z means x varies 1 by z when y is constant. Now by joint variation we can write x varies y by z when both vary. Now to convert it to equation form, I have to write down x equal to k into y by z, where k is a non-zero variation constant. Now it is given that when y equals to 5, z equals to 9, then x equal to 1 by 6. Now here I have put the values x 1 by 6 equals to k into y is given 5 and z is given 9. I have written here, from here after calculation, I have got the value of k as 3 by 10. Now, our equation is becoming x equals to k into y by z. It is becoming x equals to k means 3 by 10 we have got, 3 by 10 into y by z. Now, second part, it is given that y equals to 6, z equals to 1 by 5, then calculate the value of x. We have x equal to 3 by 10 y by z. Now here x equals to 3 into y, y means 6, and 10 into z means 1 by 5. Now after cancellation, 5 2s are 10, 2 3s are 6, 3 into 3, 9. Thus the value of x is coming 9. This is our answer. Now next one. It is given that if x varies as y, show that x plus y varies as x minus y. So to prove that, what to do? We have to prove that x plus y by x minus y equal to constant. Then our proof will be completed. Now see, x varies as y. So from here we can write x equal to k into y, where k is a non-zero variation constant. From here, what you are getting, x by y equals to k. Now we'll use componendo and dividendo. That property you have learned in ratio proportion chapter. Componendo, by componendo and dividendo, what is that? We can write numerator plus denominator by numerator minus denominator. So right hand side also k means k by 1. So we can write k plus 1 by k minus 1. So this is full constant, thus we can write x plus y by x minus y equal to constant. So from here what we can conclude, or what we can prove, that x plus y directly proportional to x minus y. That is our complete proof. Now next one, 5-2. It is given that a varies as 1 by c and c varies as 1 by b. You have to show that A varies as B. That you have to show. This is one variation, A varies as 1 by C, and that is another. So two different variation means we have to take two different variation constant. Here I am taking A equals to K1 by C and C equals to K2 by B, where k1 and k2 are two variation constant, they are non-zero variation constant. From 1, what you can write? A equals to k1 by c, and from here we have got c equals to k2 by b. So in place of c, I have written k2 by b. Thus, I am getting a equals to k1, b will go there, k1 into b by k2. That means k1 by k2 into b. Thus, A by B equals to K1 by K2, that means a constant. Thus A by B equals to constant we are getting. So what we can say, that A is directly proportional to B. Now question number 5-3. 3. It is given that if A varices B and B varices 1 by C and C varices D, then find the relation between A and D. What is given? A varices B, B varices 1 by C and C varices D. There are three different variations, so we have to take three different constants. Here I have taken A equals to K1 into B, here B equals to K2 by C and C equals to K3 into D, where K1, K2, K3 are three non-zero variation constants. Now here B equals to K2 by C, C equals to again K3 into D. In place of C, I have put K3 into D. Thus, A equals to K1 into B. So from here, value of B is K2 by K3 into D. In place of B, I have put that. So finally, what you are getting? A equals to K1 into K2 by K3 into D. So if you will cross multiply, A into D equals to K1 K2 by K3 means that is constant. So from here, A into D means constant. We can write that A is inversely proportional to D. Thus, how they are related? A and D are in indirect proportion. Clear? Now, 5.4. It is given that X varices Y, Y varices Z and Z varices X. Calculate the relation among three constant of variation. It is given X varices Y, Y varices Z and Z varices X. So from here what we can write? X equal to K1 into Y, Y equals to K2 into Z, Z equals to K3 into X, where K1, K2, K3 are three non-zero variation constant. Now here Y equals to K2Z. So in place of Z, you can write K3X. I have written here Y equals to K2 into, in place of Z, I have written K3 into X. Then X equal to K2 into K1 into Y. Thus, X equals to here, we can write here K1 into K2, K3X. From both sides, cancel X. Thus, we are getting finally K1 into K2 into K3 equals to 1. That is, the product of three variation constant is 1. This is the relation. Now, 6.1. It is given that X varies Y and No, 6.1 given X plus Y varies X minus Y. Then show that X square plus Y square varies as XY. So here X plus Y varies as X minus Y. I can write X plus Y equal to K into X minus Y, where K is a non-zero variation constant. Thus from here what you can write? X plus Y by X minus Y equals to K. Now using componendo and dividendo, what is that? This plus this. So I have written X plus Y plus X minus Y by this minus that. I have written right hand side also K plus 1 by K minus 1. Now here after YY will be cancelled out. So after adding, it is coming 2X and denominator is coming 2Y. 2X by 2Y equals to that. I have taken another constant M, where M equals to K plus 1 by K minus 1. Thus, we are getting X by Y equals to M. Now, we have to prove that X square plus Y square varies as XY. If we can prove it, that this by this equals to constant, then our proof will be completed. Now, I am writing X square plus Y square by XY equals to X equal to, from here, what we are getting? M into Y. So, in place of X, I am writing M square Y square plus Y square. And here X is MY into Y. So, X square plus Y square by XY equals to, from right hand side, we are taking Y square common. That is becoming M square plus 1 and denominator M into Y square. Now, Y square cancelled out. it is coming m square plus 1 by m. Thus, x square plus y square by xy is coming constant. So, we can prove from here that x square plus y square is directly proportional to xy. Now, your homework is sum number 6-2 and sum number 6-3. Now, in next video, you will see the next sums.